You could have the absolute best product in the world. You could have the very best marketing system. You could even have the best follow-up sequence. But if you don't understand how to get targeted quality traffic to your business, then it's a lot like having a business in the middle of nowhere, right? Hey, it's Avery here. Welcome back to another video on my channel. In this video, you're going to learn the ultimate blueprint on how to get unlimited high-quality traffic over to your business. So whether you are an affiliate marketer, whether you have your own products to sell, maybe you're in a network marketing company, maybe you're in real estate, whatever it is that you're trying to sell or promote online, this video will show you how to get unlimited high quality eyeballs to your business, your product, your service, whatever it is that you have. And in this video, I'm gonna reveal some very cool strategies that you could start using today that almost nobody is talking about. So I'm very excited to get into this. And if this is your first time on this channel, I'm always putting out new videos on a regular basis that will show you how to create passive income online. So if you enjoy these kinds of videos, then definitely be sure to hit that subscribe button down below, tick the bell icon, and this will be notified whenever there is a brand new video. But without further ado, let's get into the ultimate traffic blueprint. So right now you have something absolutely amazing to offer to the marketplace. You have this amazing product right here. You've got this amazing surface. You have something that can absolutely change someone's life in some aspect. So your primary goal is, of course, to get more customers over to your product, your service, because that way, you know, it's more potential sales, and more sales, of course, means more money for you, and more money then leads to a better life, more options, and that is primarily what your goal should be as a business owner. So how exactly do you go about getting targeted traffic over to your product? So before we actually get into the different ways and how you, of course, drive traffic, there is something very important that you should have in place before you start sending traffic, and that is something known as a sales funnel. So the way that that looks is you have something known as a capture page. So this is a simple one page where when someone lands on this page, they have two options. They see a headline at the top that says something along the lines of, you know, depending on the niche that you're in, but for example, we use health and wellness. It may say something along the lines of, would you like to learn how to get six-pack abs in the next 90 days? If so, enter your name and email number down below, and you could then request access to your free ebook or free, you know, training series, or they could, of course, decide to learn more about what you have to offer. Or you could even choose to send them directly to a sales page where they could decide to learn more about what it's all about. So you could have a video here that pretty much explains what your product or service is all about, and you could pretty much, you know, kind of show, you know, all the main, you know, benefits, all the main details. And then down here you could have the buy button. So your primary goal should be not to send people directly to a product, because if you do that, then people aren't going to necessarily, they may not be fully ready to buy. If you're sending, you know, cold traffic, especially where it's people that, you know, they don't really know who you are, then the chances are they're not going to end up buying, you know, right then and there. So your primary goal should be, of course, to focus on building up connection with your audience. You should really focus on building up your audience right here, because when someone goes to your capture page and they request more information, they will then get put into your email list where you could then follow up with them down the road. So that is, of course, another important step where you have this. You could send them back to the offer at any point. But this is primarily what you should have in place before you start sending any traffic at all. I just cannot recommend this enough. Now, when it comes to actually driving traffic, there's a few ways you can, of course, go about it. But what I actually want to go over here is something that you've probably never heard of in, you know, a lot of other videos. Because here's the big problem when it comes to driving traffic. You know, a lot of people, they talk about, okay, do Facebook ads, for example. Do solo ads. I'd say, you know, Facebook ads and solo ads, these two methods are kind of like the primary, like, most popular ways of driving traffic, right? You know, that's kind of what everyone tends to talk about. That's what every guru, you know, talks about, you know, do Facebook ads and just, you know, leverage that. But the problem with that is that if you rely on just one platform like Facebook to get all your traffic from, if you just rely on one platform like Facebook or Google, then let's say if something happens to it where, like, you know, they decide to increase their prices where it becomes harder for you to, of course, break even, or maybe they decide to ban your account, which is something that Facebook is very, you know, notorious for, then, you know, you could lose pretty much your business pretty much like that if you rely on one specific platform. So you never want to rely on one specific platform when it comes to driving traffic. What you want to do is you want to learn the strategies that you could use for pretty much any other platform right there. So when it comes to driving traffic, there's actually three levels that I want to go over. And level number one would represent this small circle right here. This represents fast results traffic. So if you are someone who's completely brand new and you want to get results rather quickly, this would be known as fast results traffic. So you have that. Level number two is a bigger circle here. And this represents strategic scale. So this is, of course, after you begin to get results at level one, you are, getting into profit. You can then progress to level number two. And then right here you have level number three. And this would be represented as domination, where, of course, as you start to get, lots of, results from level one and level two, then you could decide to progress to level three. So what exactly are the methods that you could actually get traffic from in each of these, levels here? So in this video specifically, I want to focus on level one strategies, because if you're on this video right now, then chances are you're someone who is, completely brand new, and maybe you haven't really had, much success yet. So it's best if you start with level one. And also, I don't really want, this video to, of course, get drawn out there. So let's actually start with level one traffic methods. So the very first way that you can get traffic to your offer is with something known as influencer traffic. Now, this is actually very powerful, because with influencers, as you probably know, there's, plenty of them on, sites like Instagram. You've got Facebook influencers, you've got YouTube influencers. There's a whole bunch of influencers on, pretty much every social media platform. And a lot of them, they have quite massive following. So for example, right now we're on Instagram right now, and there's an influencer by the name of Michelle Lewin. She has a following of over 13 million followers. Imagine this for a minute, right? You have 13 million people following you that are interested in what you have to offer. So whether you are in real estate, maybe you're in, the health niche, or weight loss, or maybe you're in the luxury niche, or whatever the case may be, you have 13 million people that are following you that are, of course, interested in what you have to offer. Now, really think about that for a minute. What could that do for your business? What could that really help you with? Can that make a difference in your life? I'm sure for a lot of people, this would be a massive difference right there. So with influencers, this is very powerful, because, you have an audience of people that, they know, like, and trust you. And you could literally even, in most cases, you could put up a post and have someone, buy something from you pretty much right then and there. So that is kind of, that's what a lot of these influencers are experiencing. And that's kind of, the main benefit with becoming an influencer. However, the one downside with becoming an influencer is that it is a rather long game. So you do have to be putting in lots of work rather consistently. But, the benefit is that if you're willing to put in the work consistently, then it is definitely something that can really pay off a lot in the long term. Now, if you are someone who is completely brand new, if you don't have a massive following, if you don't really feel like taking that time to really build it up personally, the question is, how exactly do you go about levering this exact strategy if you have absolutely no following? And the way that you can do this is you can go to specific sites that allow you to actually pay some of these influencers, a specific, price amount to either give you a shout out on Instagram, for example. You could pay someone on YouTube. For example, there's another influencer here by the name of Alux, and they are pretty much like a luxury channel. So you could pay an influencer like one of these to, either create a post for you on Instagram, create a video pretty much giving you a shout out. They could have your link, your program that you want to recommend, your product or service that you want to get traffic to. And you could actually siphon traffic from their audience and get very targeted, high quality traffic from one of these influencers right here. So just to kind of give you an idea, if we go on Michelle's profile right here and we scroll down a bit, if we click on this post here, for example, right here, she's pretty much talking about, something about here. And then at the very bottom, it looks like she's actually promoting another influencer here by the name of Maddie Productions. So if we go to that profile right here, this will actually open up this other influencer right here. Now, this influencer has about 14,000 followers. And what she did is, of course, she paid Michelle to, of course, get her profile out there. So this is, of course, one way that you can use to, of course, build up your following. You could also use it to, promote a specific product that you have, a specific program, whatever it is that you have to promote. But that is really the benefit with influencers. So I hope that you could see that, this is a rather powerful method that, you could use to get lots of high quality traffic very, very quickly. So again, there's influencers pretty much everywhere, but it's a really powerful method. But let's move on to the next method, which would be known as 24-hour traffic. So what exactly is 24-hour traffic? This is also known as solo ads, or it could also be referred to as email advertising. And there's a lot of, very big marketers that have, very similar to influencers, they built up a following through their email list. So for example, here's someone that I've been following for a while by the name of Igor Kafitz, and he built most of his business through email marketing. So he, primarily focused on building up a list of email subscribers. And just kind of give you an idea on, in terms of, the type of emails he puts out, Here's one that he put out that says, I'm a video game addict. I love playing video games, but I couldn't do it for a living because I couldn't find anyone who would pay to watch me play. So instead, I created a business that doesn't need me there around the clock, so I can play video games while it pays me. And then here's how I did it. He has a link to his program right there. And then as you can see here, it shows a picture of him, you know, playing games with his son, which is pretty cool right there. But, you know, he pretty much goes more into, you know, like the different games he plays, which is pretty cool. I play games every now and then. But, you know, then, of course, he links to his webinar that you can, of course, check out. So watch this webinar before it's old. So he's, you know, primarily in like the make money online or, you know, online business type of niche right there. So this pretty much goes over, you know, what it's all about. And then anyone who decides to enroll in his program, you know, that's of course, how he makes his money right there. Now, the benefit with solo ads is that you don't necessarily have to build it up organically the slow way. What you could actually do is you could pay one of these email providers. Like, for example, Igor Kafitz, he actually does have his own website called Igor Solo Ads, and you could actually pay him to create a email broadcast for you where you could have him promote, you know, whatever your offers. You could have him, you know, promote your affiliate link to his list, and then you can get your message out there really very quickly. So the benefit with this type of traffic is that you can get lots of traffic, very targeted traffic, usually delivered within 24 hours. So this is some of the fastest traffic that you could really get. Anytime you buy traffic from Igor, or even like with a big marketplaces like Udemy, for example, the benefit here is that you usually get those clicks delivered within 24 hours. So to kind of give you an idea, like let's say that, you know, I went to Udemy right here, and I decided to buy a solo ad from, you know, this Angela Vera right here. So right here it shows that, if we zoom in on here, 44% of his buyers have actually reported to getting sales, which is great. He's charging 69 cents per click. And if we click on his name right here, this will show exactly how many clicks we could, of course, order. So in this case, you could order anywhere from 100 to 1,000, you know, clicks. And of course, the more clicks you buy, the more you'd, of course, pay with those clicks right there. So for 1,000 clicks, if you want to order that, you would pay $6.93, although I would never, you know, do a test run with that specific amount, unless if I know that for sure that the traffic is good. You know, I would preferably start with maybe like 200 visitors is what I would start with. So pay like, you know, $1.41 right there. And then here's where you'd put in your link that you want to promote. So ideally, like I mentioned earlier, you want to put in the link to your capture page. And this way, you know, people can, they see exactly what you have to offer. And if they want, they could choose to request information, which then they then get put onto your email list, and then you could follow up with them later if they don't buy right away. So again, most people who see your offer, they're not going to end up buying, you know, your program or whatever it is that you have, you know, right there on the front end. Usually it takes them some, you know, they have to, of course, have time to think about it. They got to see your offer multiple times. You know, maybe you have to, of course, follow up with them with more, value. But the more consistent that you are, the more money that you're going to make in the long term. So again, this is pretty much how 24-hour traffic media works right there. But let's move on to the third method, which is with display ads. So you've probably seen, if you've ever been on any like big sites, like for example, Listverse is a very big, popular like blogging site. If we go on here and we scroll down a bit, usually there will be like an ad that will show up here. Like here's what ad for like the Metro T-Mobile iPhone right there. And of course, you know, they are targeting people who have either visited their website before or have, you know, been on some other similar site. They're targeting those specific people. And then, of course, these ads then show up on different websites that they, of course, visit. So, you know, the ads that you'll see on Listverse will depend on, you know, wherever you've, of course, been. But that's really the power of display ads right there is, you know, you could set up a banner. You can create a banner yourself. You could even go to a site like Fiverr.com and you could have someone create a banner for you. And then you can, of course, you know, get that up on certain websites that people are, of course, going to, people who you're, of course, targeting. And then you could just have them show up right there where anytime someone clicks on the ad and they, of course, decide to check it out, that's, of course, how you could, of course, make money right there. So, you know, there's Listverse right there. There's CNN, if I try scrolling down a bit. Looks like this is an ad right here for something about 4th of July. If I scroll down some more. Here's one for Fiverr, actually. This is actually interesting. I was on Fiverr actually just yesterday because I was ordering some YouTube thumbnails. That's actually where I get my thumbnails here. But, you know, right here, they're actually targeting me saying, need social media design services. So they're basically saying to me, basically, because I was on there, they're basically saying, hey, I seen you ordered some YouTube thumbnails. You know, do you need any more? You know, come back to our site if you need some more. So, you know, that's actually how Fiverr is, of course, getting customers back to their business right there. But that's it's actually known to be a very powerful way to get lots of high quality traffic is with banner ads. They're also known as display ads right there. But Let's move on to method number four, which would be known as pay-per-click, otherwise also known as PPC ads. So the way how this works is, of course, you pay whenever someone decides to click on your ad. And I'd say the top two ways of doing this would either be with Google Ads, otherwise you could also use Bing Ads for this. And really the benefit with using these two big search engines is that, think about it like this, right? Someone goes on Google, right, and they search up something very specific. Like, in my case, I put in real estate agent near me, right? The reason why I looked this up is not because I'm interested in real estate, but because I'm actually in the process of helping my grandpa with his real estate website right there. So I just happened to put this in just to kind of see what would come up. And here at the top, there's three ads about the best agents for selling, real estate agent near me. So these are different real estate agents that are, you know, advertising their business. And that's pretty much how you can, of course, get lots of high quality traffic right there. So when someone searches up something very specific and you can get your specific ad right in front of them, you know, as long as it's, of course, relevant in terms of what they're searching up, this is some of the highest quality traffic that you can get, some of the most targeted traffic, because you're getting in front of people who are actually requesting exactly what you have to offer. So they're looking up, okay, real estate agent near me. If you could provide that to them and you can get, you know, in the very top here, which with Google Ads and Bing Ads, you could actually do that, then this is some of the highest quality traffic that you can get. So that's really the benefit with pay-per-click ads. You could also do this with Facebook, although I'd say if you're doing this type of ad, I'd say it's probably best if you were to do with like a search engine like Google or Bing, or even like Yahoo, I'm sure, is another site you could use for that. But Google and Bing, these would be really powerful platforms to use if you were to use pay-per-click ads right there. So this is another really powerful method. But let's move on to the fifth method in here, the last method I actually want to show here, and that is with something known as retargeting. So retargeting is basically where you get in front of people who have already seen something that you have to offer. So the benefit with this is that, you know, think about it like this, right? Someone goes to your landing page, right? And let's say that, you know, they see your headline at the top, you know, would you like to learn how to get six-pack abs in the next 90 days? Let's say that they don't necessarily request information right away, or maybe they see your product that you're trying to sell, and they don't necessarily buy it right away. Well, you know, you do have the option of following up with them through email if you have them on the list. Otherwise, there's also the option of retargeting them again. And the benefit with this is you could actually get in front of these people again for literally pennies on the dollar. So the two sites that I would recommend for this are, you know, you could use Google Ads. Otherwise, another great platform to use is with Facebook. Now, I know I kind of mentioned earlier, I'm not a huge fan of Facebook ads. I don't like Facebook ads at all. I think that for most people, unless if you're like some big massive brand, which is, you know, what Facebook and Google tends to really prefer, Facebook ads is a very risky way of running your business, because, I mean, think about it like this. You're relying on a platform like Facebook, and Facebook is known to be a very strict platform, especially for people in the make money online or business niche. They're a very strict platform. If you say the wrong thing, they could shut your account down. They've also been increasing the prices quite a lot as time goes along. So it's becoming a lot harder to get into profit with Facebook ads. But that being said, when it comes to retargeting people, when it comes to getting in front of people who have seen your offer already, you could actually get in front of them again. It's a very powerful way to, of course, get in front of the right audience. So if you, of course, get in front of people who have seen your landing page before, and, you know, they, of course, see it again, because, you know, people are, of course, you know, busy, they may not, you know, have time to, you know, go through it, you know, right away. But if you can get in front of these people a second time, then this is some of the highest quality traffic that you could really get in the long term. So the way that this would work is you would have to install a Facebook pixel, or also a Google pixel on your landing page, on your sales page. And then that is how, you know, whenever someone goes to that page, it then fires that pixel, and then they get put into your Facebook audience right there. And that is how you, of course, retarget them. So those five ways are just some of the methods that are taught with this exact blueprint right here. And if you want to learn how to do all this stuff step by step, if you want to learn more in depth about how to do all this stuff, because let's face it, this exact strategy right here, this is, you know, of course, some of the most powerful ways of, you know, getting lots of high quality traffic. But if you want to learn more about how to do all this stuff step by step, and you want to learn, you know, a lot more the more advanced methods as well, then all you have to do is click on the first link down below, and that'll take you over to this page right here, where you could actually get the Mass Traffic Blueprint completely for free. So this blueprint right here, you could actually download for free. As you can see here, you just click on the download button, and you could download it to your computer, you could print it out, you could laminate it, you could even put it up on your wall if you want to do that. And then also, if you want to, of course, learn more about how to deploy this entire strategy, you know, step by step, then there will be an option to do that as well. But at the very least, you owe it to yourself to download this blueprint, because this blueprint is known to be a very powerful method, and it's been known to get lots of results for many marketers out there. But anyways, hope you got lots of value in this video. If you did, be sure to let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. Give this a thumbs up if you got lots of value here, and take care.